Hi everyone, I am very pleased to be here today to have the possibility to tell you about our project towards a cure for IPEX syndrome with two different approaches, engineered Treg replacement or stem cell gene editing. So monogenic diseases of the immune system are represent about 400 of among the 7,000 monogenic diseases and manifest not only with immune deficiencies, meaning increased susceptibility to infections, but also with autoimmunity, depending on the different genes that are involved by the genetic impairment. And importantly, so the one category of this disease are the tregopathies, so they in which really the genes that are impaired are impairing the function of Treg cells, very important cells to regulate the immune system, and in particular FOXP3 is the gene that is mutated in IPEX syndrome, of which we are going to talk today. In IPEX patients, what happens is that the T regulatory cells normally develop within the thymus during the fetal life and soon after birth. They are impaired because of this transcription factor, which is essential for their function, is not working. And therefore, this causes their inability of these dysfunctional Treg cells to control T effector cells, which by consequence, they attack the different organs, not recognizing the self anymore, and in particular, they attack pancreas, skin, gut, and kidney, generated severe enteropathy, eczema, type 1 diabetes, and you know, nephropathy and autoimmune hepatitis, and so on. This disease, importantly, is as a fatal outcome if it is not rapidly diagnosed and treated, and actually this is probably what happened in the past. The disease has an age onset very early in life. As you can see, most of the patients basically have the onset of the disease within 1 year, and half of them within the first month. And definitely, the awareness of the disease has also increased, has also been reflected in the increased incidence of the disease. Besides the main triad of symptoms, which is diarrhea, type 1 diabetes, and eczema, in the progression of the disease, many other organs can be affected. And of course, there is a very severe failure to thrive. And interestingly, IPEX is the disease among all the immune regulatory disorders in which type 1 diabetes is more frequent. So what happened to these patients? What do we have right now for their treatment? The approaches are essentially two. One is immunosuppression by pharmacological intervention, and the other one is hematopoietic stem cell transplantation. Now, both these approaches are insufficient and unsatisfactory because so the transplant is really has limited survival, and the pharmacological treatment, if we look at the disease-free survival, is really insufficient in guarantee a long life control of the disease, and therefore, you know, it's really for the patient is really insufficient to reach the wellness. So we have, of course, gene therapy approaches, which are for the FOXP3 extremely demanding because FOXP3 is a transcription factor with differential expression in a different cell subset of the body. So it is very highly expressed and always expressed in FOXP3. Positive T regulatory cells, which are a tiny bit cell subset in the blood, and whereas it is transiently expressed, but also very important in controlling immune responses during, you know, in any T cells that becomes activated and fight against the pathogens. So, but because of the Treg are the main a subset affected, we ask whether Treg replacement therapy would be curative, or even also if every patient would need a bone marrow transplantation or can be cured by this Treg cell approach. So the Treg cells, the gene therapy approaches that are nowadays pursued by different groups are basically two. One is the functional replacement of Treg, and the other one is the physiological regulated expression of the gene in hematopoietic stem cells. And at Stanford, we are developing both the Treg replacement therapy and the gene editing approach. With the Treg replacement therapy, already several years ago, we have observed that by transducing T cells, so normal CD4 effector T cells, with a wild type FOXP3 under a constitutive promoter, we can generate a subset of cells which express FOXP3 at very high level, exactly like Treg, physiological Treg would do. And we can do that in the autologous patient cells and then purify them and reinfuse them with very limited toxicity. These cells really become like the T regulatory cells, as they, you know, from the phenotypic point of view, but also in their suppressive activity, and they are very stable also when they are exposed to inflammatory condition. We are now towards the phase one cell therapy development with this cell product, and we have already validated this cell product in several humanized mice, and also we are doing the GMP process development with the idea of filing the IND to the FDA in the next year, in 2021, and the CIRM funding for this is really essential. Basically, the other important aspect of this cell product is that once we use in IPEX, you know, can be used also in many other different diseases, such as inflammatory bowel diseases, graft versus host, and other autoimmune diseases in which Treg deficiency is a problem to be overcome and is responsible of the pathology. And this cell product represent several advantages as compared to Treg cell therapy products that are already in the clinic. One of these is the guarantee of stability. The other one, for example, is the easy to be manufactured, because the starting subset is the CD4 positive T cells and not the T regulatory cells. But of course, the real question is treatment versus cure. Would the HSC-based gene editing for IPEX syndrome be really the ultimate goal to cure IPEX and to provide long-lasting wild-type FOXP3 gene expression under physiological regulation? With this question in mind, we are also working on preclinical studies using CRISPR-Cas9 for FOXP3 gene correction in the hematopoietic stem cells of the patient, and we have already produced very nice data on feasibility of this approach. What we do in particular is we transfer the FOXP3 gene, the all coding sequence, so that we can, with one gene therapy approach, cover all the different mutated genes that the patients may have, and we insert this coding sequence after the regulatory sequence together with a marker gene, which allow us to follow the cells that are genetically modified. By doing so, we know that we can replace at least 50% of the normal physiological expression of FOXP3 and also of its function, and we can generate, as we tested in vivo in humanized mice, we can generate functional T regulatory cells, although in a little bit decreased amount as compared to normal donor cells. So we are still working at the preclinical level on this cell product. And so as as a conclusion towards the cure of IPEX syndrome, of course, working here on that has been really increasing the awareness of IPEX disease, the unmet need and the possibility of a better treatment, the support of CIRM on the CD4LV-FOXP3 project, allowing the IND filing is absolutely important and critical for the success of this project, and the pioneering gene editing is also another promising innovative approach. And if you want to know more about what is life with IPEX, please go to the blog of CIRM and listen to the story of a dear patient of ours, which is, you know, it was really so kind to advocate for a cure. It's touching. Thank you very much. Thank you, CIRM. And also thank you to all my FOXP3 team in the lab and Roncarolo lab, in which with whom I always work since many, many years. And thank you all for your attention.